If there was an aha moment that inspired us to start CodeX, a few folks actually here at Stanford, including Harry Certain, Josh Walker, Mike Chinesset, Professor Peggy Radin, we decided to have a workshop to think about, you know, the role of technology in the future of our legal system. And we said, oh, why not sort of create a lab or a center that sits between law school and the computer science department with a mission, thinking about ways that information technology can make the legal system more efficient. And legal empowerment through information technology became our guiding theme, our motto.
It was the computational law laboratory, like, how can we help people? Right? Like, there's a lot of amazing intellectual stuff. It was inspiring to see how law and computer science intersected and resonated and are profoundly connected with each other.
CodeX fit a really great place because it would be a place where not just where you would do research, but where people could bring ideas for, you know, changes in technology and things that could be done to improve legal services. And we would help, you know, nurture them, and you could actually take them out into the world. No other law school had really done, but that fit so nicely with the ethos of Stanford and Silicon Valley and all of that.
That's really the Stanford spirit that CodeX has brought forth, is this interdisciplinarity, this idea to think outside the box. Very few law schools, and really Stanford was largely the epicenter of this, with CodeX, was focused on how can technology improve law, legal practice? Can computer science teach us anything about law and different ways to think? And now we have a true established center here, a home for the legal tech community in much of the world.
But I also think Stanford offers an opportunity that no other school in the country offers for people who actually are interested in developing and building the tools for legal technology. We've spun out an enormous number of startups here. We run Future Law. We've got in Silicon Valley a law school that produces entrepreneurs and new companies, right? And that's something you're not going to find anywhere else.
What I advise students to do is that if they have particular interest in technology, we have great centers like CodeX where they can get a deeper understanding of the intersection of technology and law.
If you think you're too big for the small things, don't be surprised if you're too small for the big things. CodeX was not too big for the small things. We were there trying to like etch out everything we could with what we had. And as a result, I think we are best positioned for dealing with the extremely complicated, extremely heavy questions of what do we do in a world where computers can read or computers can adjudicate. As AI gets further and further, I think the work we did before computers could do much has brought together the right community, the right mix of folks. I can't guarantee we'll get it right, but I think it gives us our best chance.
The fundamental motto that we have at CodeX is legal empowerment through technology. And so this is at the core of our mission, and every version of every tool we think about building and researching, our minds and our first priority is making it accessible to everyone.
We start asking, what are the ways in which we can use this technology to make the world a better place, to improve the deliverance of legal services, to allow people actual better access to the rights and remedies that our laws confer upon them?
At the time, I was doing my undergrad in Slovenia, where things in the legal tech were just not happening yet. And I then found CodeX with many engagements openly available on the internet. All of a sudden, I was in an international community that was much more interdisciplinary, so things got easier. For me, CodeX has a special place. It was kind of the cornerstone that kept me going and led me to where I am today.
This is actually the hub of where students and faculty and industry are interacting. CodeX has been a tremendous convener of talent. This has not just had an impact within the Stanford, Silicon Valley, and the law community that we touch, but because of how we've influenced some of the largest players in legal technology, we've had an impact nationally and around the world.
I think CodeX has been instrumental in how I think about my future and what I want to go into. I think I've really discovered here this intersection of law and computation that is very fascinating to me.
there are many individuals like me for whom CodeX has been a constant career partner and accelerator. At an individual level, it has been game-changing for our industry and has been the catalyst for many successful new businesses, business models, and academic work.
I still think we've only scratched the surface of things, and there's so much more that we have to do. The legal system is far from being perfect. I think CodeX should be the place for people to connect and sort of chart the future of the legal system. And, you know, I invite you all to join us. I think, you know, it's a wonderful community here, and, you know, become a part of it.
As the new dean of Stanford Law, I congratulate the leaders of CodeX for 2 decades of remarkable accomplishment and look forward to what it has in store for us in the next chapter.